Hi guys, so today we will discuss about class 10 chapter number 1 of science, which is chemical reaction and equation. So in this video we will discuss about 10 things: introduction, chemical reaction, balance chemical equation, combination reaction, decomposition reaction, displacement reaction, double displacement reaction, oxidation reaction, reduction reaction, and in last we will do recap. So we will start from introduction. So you might have observed many chemical changes in your daily life, like rusting of iron, curding of milk, burning of crackers, rotting of fruits, and so on. Like if we take an iron nail and keep it in a moist atmosphere, what will you observe? After some days, you will observe that the iron nail has started rusting. This happens because of chemical change. Our next topic is chemical reaction. So, in chemical reaction, when we burn magnesium ribbon in presence of oxygen, we get magnesium oxide. Right? 2Mg plus O2 gives out 2MgO. Magnesium plus oxygen gives out magnesium oxide. So, for better understanding, let's perform an activity. So,
this is a burner and a matchbox, a strip of magnesium ribbon, a watch glass, and a pair of tongs. First, burn the burner with the help of matchbox and hold the magnesium ribbon with the help of pair of tongs and start burning magnesium ribbon. When magnesium ribbon start burning, you can see a white dazzling flame. When magnesium ribbon completely burns, you can see a white powder substance. Do you know what it is? That is magnesium oxide.
So, for balancing any chemical equation, you need to know these 3 points. First, adjust the coefficient, not the subscript. Second, even or odd, multiplies by 2 to make all even. Third, check the balance equation. So, now we need to know how to balance any chemical equation. So, for example, if we take Al plus H2O gives out Al2O3 plus H2. Is it a balanced chemical equation? No, because the number of reactant and the number of products are not the same. If the numbers are not the same, we cannot say the equation balanced. So we need to balance it now. So for after balancing, we get 2Al plus 3H2O gives out Al2O3 plus 3H2. So, for balancing any chemical equation, we need to multiply by 2. You can see, if there is no subscript charge, if there is no charge, we can conclude 1. So, 2 1s are 2, aluminium we get 2 in reactant part. Now, 3 2s are 6. So, hydrogen we get 6. And oxygen, 3 1s are, if there is no charge, we can conclude 1. 3 1s are 3. We get 3. So, in product side, aluminium 2, then oxygen 3, then 3 2s are 6, hydrogen 6. So, now we can say this is a balanced chemical equation? Yes, because the number of reactant and the products numbers are both are same. So, we can say this is a balance capital equation. So our next topic is combination reaction. So in combination reaction, if there is two or more than two reactant, but the product we get, that will be single. That is known as combination reaction. Look, if there is two or more than two reactant, but the product we get, that will be single, that is known as combination reaction. For example, number one, A plus B plus C gives out ABC. So in this equation, A plus B plus C is a reactant and ABC is a product. You can see there is three reactant, but the product we get, that is single, which is ABC. Product 1, reactant 3. Example number 2, 2mg plus O, 2, O2 gives out 2mgO. So in this equation, there is two reactant, but here also the product is single. In any equation, it doesn't matter the reactant will be 2 or more than 2, but the product we get, that will be single. That is known as combination reaction. So our next topic is decomposition reaction. So in decomposition reaction, just opposite of combination reaction. In combination, we have learned two or more than two reactant but single product. And in decomposition reaction, one reactant but many small products. Like in this equation, there is one reactant, which is CaCO3, but there is two product, CaO and CO2. There is two product. So in any equation, the single reactant but many small products are known as decomposition reaction. So our next topic is displacement reaction. So in displacement reaction, the upper element will displace lower element. For understanding displacement reaction, you need to know this chart. So in top we have K, then Na, Ca, Mg, Al, Zm, Fe, Pb, H, Cu, Hg, Ag, Au, and in last we have Pt. So the upper element will display lower element. For example, A plus Bc gives out Ac plus B. So which is upper, A or B? A, no? So A will display B and come in place of B, then it will be, the product will be AC plus B. Like example number 1, if we take Fe plus CuSO4, there is no space, that's why I have written here. So who is upper, the Fe or Cu? Let's check. Fe is here and Cu is here. So who is up? Fe, no? So Fe will display Cu. So after displacing, it will come in place of Cu. So the product will be FeSO4 plus Cu. Look, the Fe has displaced Cu and come in place of Cu. So in example number 2, Fe plus H2SO4. So let's check who is bigger, Fe or H2. So F is here and H is here. So again F is bigger than H. So Fe will display H and come in place of H. So the product will be FeSO4 plus H2. So remember this thing, the upper one will display the lower one. You can note down this chart. So our next topic is double displacement reaction. So in double displacement reaction, both equation will interchange each other. Like for example, AB plus CD gives out AC plus BD. Look, A will interchange with C and B will interchange with D. So for example number 1, NaSO4 plus SRCl2. So this will interchange. So it will come NaCl and SrSO4. The both will equation will interchange. Then in example number 2, HCl plus Na NaOH gives out NaCl plus H2O. So Na will interchange with Cl and H will interchange with O. The product will come NaCl plus H2O. So in any equation, the equation there will be interchange, that is known as double displacement reaction. So our next topic is oxidation reaction. So in oxidation reaction, gaining of oxygen and losing of hydrogen is known as oxidation reaction. Hydrogen, in which equation the hydrogen is gained or oxygen will be lose, that is known as oxidation reaction. Like 2Zn plus O2 gives out ZnO. In this equation the oxygen is gaining, so this is oxidation reaction. Example number 2, 2Cu plus O2 gives out 2CuO. In this equation also the oxygen is gaining, that's why this is also an oxidation reaction. So our last topic is reduction reaction. So reduction reaction is just opposite of combination reaction. In combination reaction we have learnt that gaining of oxygen and losing of hydrogen, and in reduction reaction gaining of hydrogen, losing of oxygen. In any equation the hydrogen is gained or oxygen is lose, that is known as reduction reaction. So today's video we have learnt about introduction, chemical reaction, how to balance chemical reaction, combination reaction, decomposition reaction, displacement reaction, double displacement reaction, oxidation reaction, reduction reaction. So thank you guys.